Hi, we are going to start the NDC eLibrary tutorial series by explaining how you can access the platform and log into your account for full text access. Just visit ndc.refread.com for the eLibrary. Do not use www in the URL. ndc.refread.com is good enough. Before I explain how you can log in, some of the reasons why you need to log in are as follows. When you are not in the campus, login is mandatory. You can access full text of the content in the campus even without logging in, but when you are not in the campus, you need to log in to have any full text access. For other personalized features like saving content for future reference or sharing it with your peers or setting up automatic email alerts for latest news or latest issues, or if you want to place any specific request for an article or an ebook, you will be required to log in. Some of these features you cannot use without logging in. In general, also, we recommend that users log in into the platform because that helps us assess the performance of the platform and see whether the platform is delivering enough and relevant results to match your reading needs. Let's just dive into the platform and see how you can log in. On your top right, you see this login button. Just click here. By default, the locker ID option is selected. You can choose to log in either using your locker ID or your email address. But whatever you choose to log in, please make sure that you give the form the correct details. If you choose email address, then you enter email address. If you choose the locker ID, then you please do enter the locker ID. We have seen people making that mistake. So I'm going to first try logging in using the locker ID. I just give in the locker ID and the password and I'm logged in. I'll repeat this step by logging in using my email address. So this time I'm selecting email address. The password remains the same. For both locker ID and email address, the password is same. So this time I've logged in using my email address. If you click on your name, there's this change password link and you can reset your password by just first entering your current password and then the new password of your choice. You need to do it twice and then click on change password and then your password will be reset. Even without logging in, you can reset your password in case you forget your old password. You just click on this forgot password link. The platform will ask you for your locker ID or your email address. So I'm just going to add my email address for now. Yeah, I'll add ndclibrary@gmail.com, my email address. And if I click on this reset password button, the platform will send me an email with the reset password link. All you need to do is just click on the link and then you can, you are authenticated and you can set up your new password. There are a couple of things that you need to be cautious of. The platform can block the IP address of your network in case there are more than 4 unsuccessful attempts to log in. So please make sure that you use your correct login details. This happens generally when you are trying to do login from outside the campus. This is to keep the unauthorized users away from the platform. Also, your account can be blocked in case the system suspects any misuse. This generally happens if you share your account details with other people for giving them access to the content in the platform, or if there is some robotic behavior in the download patterns. These security measures are there to protect the intellectual property of the subscribed publishers. In the next tutorial, we will explain how you can search the platform for relevant content. If you have any queries or need any support, you can always write to us or WhatsApp us at this number. Happy reading!